This is the closest that we've been allowed to get to El Chapo's tunnel, the tunnel he used in his brazen escape on Saturday night. It is, by all accounts, a magnificent feat of engineering. So let's come on in and see exactly what El Chapo here had in store. This is a small little exit, just a couple feet wide and a couple feet long. You see, with a ladder, maybe about 10-foot, 15-foot ladder that leads down into that tunnel. The room here is nothing to brag about. It's empty, full of cinder blocks, and you can see these containers full of dirt here, these wheelbarrows full of dirt.
Here we go. Vamos a ir por abajo. Okay. And loose. Here's another ladder leading down into another deeper section of the tunnel. Ways down.
You can see here, this is the modified motorcycle that investigators showed us images of before. This is on a track. It seems to roll back and forth. See that? There's buckets left behind, and look at this. Left behind oxygen tanks as well, in order for them to survive down here. It is a very tight space. I can't even stand up. I'm about 5'10". I can't even stand up all the way. It is just a remarkable feat of engineering. The tunnel stretches for more than a mile, carved out earth here, this modified train tracks for that mini motorcycle. You see here, electricity lines. It's very difficult to breathe down here. A lot of dirt, dust. This here for the ventilation system. Tight space down here. But for a man known as El Chapo, I'm sure he had more than enough room to work with. This motorcycle was on a track here. This is the bike that El Chapo used to ride out of the prison. It still has gas in it. You could still smell the gas, this overwhelming odor of gas in this tight space. It really is suffocating.